The Wood Whisperer is sponsored by Powermatic and Typebond.
Ever since SketchUp came out with their free web app and stopped supporting their free desktop app, people have been getting pretty nervous about it and kind of panicking because the web version is quite different if you're used to the desktop version. And it's been a little bit tricky to use, tricky to get your files there, but things have improved over time. In fact, we just came out with a course on SketchUp that shows you how to use the free version, and it is pretty fully functional, but you do need an internet connection to access it, and that can be a problem for some people. Totally understand that, but I wanted to show you guys how you could still use this free version to do a few different things. One is to take a file, because we still use SketchUp here at the Wood Whisperer and in the Guild. You could take that file, no matter what version of SketchUp it was made in, and you can import that into the free web app. And then, not only can you then navigate the file, but you can also export that file if, let's say, you're using an older version of SketchUp on your desktop. You can still download, at least right now, SketchUp Make 2017 if you want a desktop version. Now, I don't know how long they're going to keep supporting that, but it is available today. So if you need to take a 2020 Pro file and export that for 2017, you can do that using the free web app, right? So this video is actually a screencast by my buddy Brian Benham. He does all of our plans in the Guild and on the free site. Very talented woodworker in his own right, but also knows his way around SketchUp. And he has a course in the Guild. If you're really interested in this stuff, it's Introduction to SketchUp and focuses on the free version, which is a little bit different if you're not used to it. So you could check that out, but these couple of tips I think will really help you if you're still a SketchUp user and you want to be able to navigate all the files and not pay anything for it.
I'm Brian Benham, and I'm here to talk to you about opening your Guild files in the SketchUp free web app. So I'm on the Guild site, and this works for any of the files we provide on the free site as well. I'm going to go down here to the executive desk to use this as our example project. I'm going to go to the Plans tab, and then just click the most recent SketchUp file. And it's downloading to my Downloads folder, and this is most likely how your computer's set up as well. So I'm going to open a clean web browser, and I'm going to go to sketchup.com/app. And to sign into the free app, you either need a Trimble account or sign in with your Gmail account. All right, now that I'm signed in, I'm going to go to Open in my computer and navigate to my Downloads folder and just select my SketchUp file and open it. And even though these SketchUp files are made in the SketchUp Pro version, you can still open them in the SketchUp free web app, and they are still completely editable. All right, let's talk about scenes. So if you've used SketchUp before, like an older version like SketchUp Make 2017, you are probably used to having your scenes across the top. So there is a little bit of a difference. It's in a different spot. If you look at this movie icon here, that will bring up your scenes, and all your scenes are along the side. So you can still navigate to all your different scenes. Let's talk about making changes. So even though this file was created in SketchUp Pro, you can still make changes in the SketchUp Free. So if you wanted to make this 10 and longer, let's say a half inch longer, you can P to push pull, pull it out, 0.5 enter, and now you've edited it. Now it's a half inch longer. And if you wanted to take this change back out into the shop, let's say you wanted to put some dimensions on it, we'll go over here to the tape measure, grab our dimensions tool, put our dimension on there so we would know when we get out into the shop that that is an inch and a half. All right, let's print it out. All right, now to take that change out into the shop, you want to go up to the menu bar here, go to Export, Export as a PNG, and then click down here on the right-hand side, Export as PNG. All right, large images may take a bit longer to export, that's fine. All right, so now if we go to our Downloads folder, we can open that up. And there's our scene with our inch and a half change that we can print out. You just click print, and then it'll print it out, and you can take it out to the shop and get to work building. All right, let's jump back into the SketchUp web app so I can show you a few other things. Now, you can also save this file to your SketchUp account. So you can click Save and go into your SketchUp folder and enter a name. So this is the executive desk. Click Save. So now that file is saved in your SketchUp account up in the cloud. So you could take your laptop out to your shop, open that file up, and get to work building it. All right, so now let's close out of this. We'll go to Home, So now there is our executive desk file. So if we go out to the shop with our laptop, you can reopen this back up out there. I should mention you do need an internet connection out in your shop. All right, here at the Wood Whisperer, since we make all of our files using the latest version of SketchUp Pro, if you're running an older desktop version, you will not be able to open the latest profile on your older version. However, the web app has you covered. So let's talk about how we're going to do that. So if we go back up here to our menu bar and go down to download, it gives you a list of options of what you can download to. As of this recording, you can download all the way down to 2017. Who knows what they have in store in the future, if they're going to each year, if they're going to allow you to download all the way down that far, but you still have that option available as of this recording. So if you wanted to download it to make 2017, you can click OK and ask you to save as file. And it is downloading a 2017 make file for you to open in your older SketchUp version. All right, I hope this has helped you open and navigate your Wood Whisperer SketchUp files using the free SketchUp web app. If you want to know more about how to use SketchUp as a 3D modeling tool, please check out my Intro to SketchUp class at the Wood Whisperer Guild. It is geared towards woodworkers. We cut right to the chase on how to use the basic tools to get you drawing your furniture designs.